Today our topic is sexual reproduction in flowering plants. So in this now the topic is pistil, megasporangium, embryo sac. Already we discussed about male reproductive organ, stamen, microsporophyll, microsporangium and also on pollen grain. Now our discussion is about pistil. So pistil or carpel. So you know the male reproductive organ is androecium, female reproductive organ is called gynoecium. So here the gynoecium made up of carpels. Gynoecium made up of carpel, carpel or pistil. Look at here. The carpel structure, basal swollen part and some elongated part, apical part, like the three parts are there in each carpel. Basal swollen part is called ovary. This is ovary. Middle elongated part is called style. This is style. Apical part which receives the pollen grains is called stigma. Inside the ovary only ovules are present. These are the ovules. So here very important point, in the ovary ovules are present. Mode of arrangement of ovules in the ovary is called placentation. Where the ovules are attached to the ovary, that is called, that part is called placenta. Mode of arrangement of ovules in the ovary is called placentation. Where the ovules are attached to the ovary, that is called placenta. It is very clear. Middle elongated part is called style. The tip part is called stigma. Pollen grains falls on the stigma. When the gynoecium made up of only one carpel, that is called monocarpillary gynoecium. Monocarpillary gynoecium. Example Dorcas. Example Dorcas beans. Have a seat, family member. Whereas when the gynoecium made up of two carpels, that is called bicarpillary gynoecium. And especially when you take in Datura, Datura I am taking, there the two ovaries are fused to form single ovary. Two styles are fused to form single style. Two stigmas are fused to form single stigma. It's a bicarpillary. Bicarpillary syncarpus. Syncarpus means the carpels are completely fused. So it is the syncarpus gynoecium. Bicarpillary. Syncarpus gynoecium. Example, Datura. Whereas in some plants on thalamus, all the carpels are free. There is no fission in the ovary or style or stigma. This is called apocarpus. It is called apocarpus gynoecium. Example, Nilambo. Example, Nilambo. So, monocarpillary gynoecium, bicarpillary gynoecium. It is mono and this one is bicarpillary. Like that, bi, tri, pentacarpillary. Example, hibiscus. If this one is, Nilambo is apocarpus gynoecium. All the carpels are free on thalamus. On thalamus, all the carpels are free. Anyway, inside the ovary, one ovule may be present, or two are present, or many ovules are present. Only one ovule is seen in, you know, in paddy. How many ovules are present? Only one ovule. In that grain, only one seed is present in paddy. Or in wheat also, only one ovule in that ovary. In mango also, only one ovule. Whereas in papaya and watermelon you take, in papaya and watermelon, papaya and watermelon, how many ovules are present? Many ovules are present inside the ovary. So number of ovule may be one too many. So only one ovule, paddy, wheat, mango. Many ovules are seen in papaya, watermelon. Anyway, we are going to ovule structure. This is the structure of the ovule. Ovule is megasporangium. Pollen sac is microsporangium. Ovule, megasporangium. This is the ovule. stalk part of the ovule. This is the stalk part, and you take this is the ovary. Stalk part of the ovule is called funiculus. Where the ovule is attached to the ovary, that part is called the placenta. Placenta. This is the stalk part. It is the body of the ovule. Where the stalk part of the ovule attached to the body of the ovule, that is called hilum. That part is called hilum. Here, this is the ovule. The ovule containing the diploid tissue. Diploid tissue is present in the ovule. That diploid tissue is called nucellus. That diploid tissue nucellus covered by integument. Integument. It is the protective layer. That integument 1 to 2. 1 or 2 are present. So here, this is the protective layer integument. This is the diploid tissue nucellus covered by integument. But apical part no integument. That apical pore is present. Apical pore of the ovule is called micropyle. Actually, pollen tube is entered into the ovule through micropyle. Pollen tube is entered into the ovule through micropyle. This is the apical part. Whereas the basal part is called chalaja. So that new cell is covered by integument. This is the basal part and this is the apical part. Apical part is called micropyle. Basal part is called chalaja. Okay. Here two layers are present. Outer layer is called testa. Inner layer is called tegmen. It's okay. After fertilization, ovule developed into seed. You know that one. But here important point one by one we have to discuss. In the ovule, diploid tissue is present that is called nucellus. One of the cell in the nucellus act as megaspore mother cell. Megaspore mother cell is diploid. Megaspore mother cell is diploid. Remember that one. The diploid megaspore mother cell is the last cell for sporophytic generation. Megaspore mother cell now undergoes meiotic division. So when it undergoes meiotic division, you know, four haploid cells are formed. Four haploid cells. Now it is in gametophytic, haploid. Before meiosis, it is diploid. After meiosis, it is haploid. Before meiosis, it is diploid. After meiosis, haploid. So four haploid cells are formed. In that four haploid cells, three are degenerate. Fourth one is the functional megaspore. Now this is the megaspore. Megaspore is haploid. Megaspore mother cell is diploid. Megaspore is the first cell for gametophytic generation. Now this is the megaspore, haploid. Now this megaspore, there the haploid nuclei, it undergo divisions. It means when first mitotic division takes place, two nuclei are formed. Again, in the second mitotic division takes place, four nuclei are formed. Again, in the third mitotic division is over, how many nuclei are formed? Eight nuclei are formed. First time mitotic, second time mitotic, third time mitotic. So when three times mitotic division takes place, how many nuclei are formed? Four plus four. First division, one plus one. Next time, two plus two. Next division, four plus four. That is the arrangement. So here, four nuclei are present towards chalaja. Four nuclei are present towards micropyle. After three times mitotic division, eight nuclei are formed. Among these four, one haploid nuclei migrated to the center. From these four nuclei, one nuclei migrated to the center. Now, what is the arrangement? 3 plus 2 plus 3. So, 1 plus 1, 2 plus 2, next 4 plus 4, next 3 plus 2 plus 3. Clear? Okay. After this division, after mitotic division, cellularization takes place, means the cell wall formation. So now cell wall formation is forming. This is the cell wall. Cell wall. This is the cell wall. After cell wall formation, here how many cells? Three cells are present towards Charaja. Three cells are present towards micropyle. Only one cell is present at the central cell. This is the central cell containing how many haploid nuclei? Two haploid nuclei. Remember that one. So nuclear arrangement 3 plus 2 plus 3, but cell arrangement is 3 plus 1 plus 3. So cells, seven celled. How many nuclei? 8 nucleated. Seven celled, 8 nucleated structure is formed inside the ovule. That seven celled, 8 nucleated structure is called embryo sac. Now this is called embryo sac.